Well, what do we want to listen to then, Beverly?
Demis Roussos.
Ever and ever, forever and ever, you'll be the one.
Demis Roussos always seemed to be this unlikely heartthrob, didn't he? Because he was totally the wrong shape, as they wore all these ridiculous caftans, and yet women adored him.
Ever and ever, forever and ever, you'll be my dream.
Different, he was, with a capital D.
Rainbows end.
He could sing the news and make it sound happy or sad. He could sing the Bible and put it over in so many different ways.
Destiny.
He was cruel in the caftan.
Eternally.
The image was part of a snowball that has been created through record companies and managements. The most important thing in my head was the music.
He actually has a track record which is quite interesting if you go into it. He was in a fairly progressive band called Aphrodite's Child with Vangelis early in his life, in which he played bass.
A dishy young Demis and his psychedelic chums had a hippie hit in 1968 with this sandal tapper.
Rain and tears in the sun.
We did three albums. Two of them were like pop albums, and the third one was a much more serious album.
After going all apocalyptic, Aphrodite's Child split, and Demis went solo. Hits like Goodbye, My Love turned him into a massive star in the rest of Europe.
Goodbye, my love! Goodbye!
But here, his British record label struggled to interpret his unique appeal.
We've got a big problem here. How the hell do we break Demis Roussos in this country? And I said, well, I think I've got a germ of a song called Happy to Be on an Island in the Sun that's about beaches, and it's the sort of feel that Demis Roussos would like.
Hey, we've got a great guest on the show.
Have we really?
Yeah. He's a big star on the continent.
Oh, yes.
He's a super singer, and he's Greek. It's Demis Roussos.
Oh, anyone for Demis?
Sitting in the sun waiting for a señorita to show.
Two or three weeks it charted. That set the whole ball rolling.
The smell of sweet roses through each and every one.
The Roussos phenomenon can be explained in one word, which is holiday.
It conjured up that image of sunshine, relaxing, romance.
A fling they might have had with a Greek on an island, a Greek lover.
The Roussos phenomenon even merited its own documentary, confirming Demis would last longer than just one night of Mediterranean passion.
This man is an enigma, a gentle giant with a mysterious power to hypnotize millions. He is a phenomenon and fast becoming a living legend.
His lavish lifestyle provided a marble-coated, gold-plated alternative to humdrum 70s suburbia.
I was so gobsmacked at this house. The marble staircases, just all the marble in the bathroom as well. It was just something that I hadn't really, really seen. And Demis was very proud of his home. I do think that part of his appeal had to do with the fact that he looked like and lived as a real superstar.
I always liked to live comfortably, and I still do. And today I live even more comfortably than back then.
It was opulent. We went to Paris, and I think we turned up at his mini chateau at about 12 o'clock and told his servants that we were there. But in fact, Demis didn't make his regal appearance till about an hour later in full flowing robes.
He liked the best of everything, as most people would. He was a connoisseur of food, and I'm sure he had the best wine, drank champagne. Why shouldn't he have the best? Why shouldn't he lavish himself with all these goods? I would.
In four mica-topped homes everywhere, millions more women were seduced, and Demis was propelled to the top of the charts.
The time now is the time on Top of the Pops for the number one. And what is the really big thing in Greece at the moment? No, not a BBC hamburger. It's Demis Roussos.
It was a big hit all over the world because it's a good song.
Ever and ever, forever.
did actually see on Top of the Pops one evening. I was laid on the floor watching him and I was just mesmerised by the whole song. My dream come true, my ghost. He sings like he's speaking to you specifically, and a lot of women out there really can feel that. My goodness, everyone wants a man to talk to them like he sang. My sin for me. He's very manly as well. I mean, did you see that big hairy chest?
Gorgeous. And it wasn't just that hairy chest that sent temperatures rising. The sun-kissed strains of Forever and Ever provided a sweltering soundtrack to the long, hot summer of 1976.
That was the one that everybody wanted to hear. And he was very happy to sing it.
Demis's ample Greek charms translated into bumper ticket sales at venues across Britain.
You could feel people getting more and more excited. And then all of a sudden, in the middle of the stage, appeared Demis Roussos, and he was enormous at that time. In this huge white satin caftan, which was like volumes of material.
His arms spread out, almost like a religious prophet, just stand there with the music surrounding him.
Ever and ever, forever and ever, you'll be the one.
Afterwards, you would often get people coming backstage.
And please don't push.
English women are wonderful. I love them because I love women. They are very important for us. We can't do without them.
It's absolutely fantastic, out of this world, yes. I come again and again and again. I go to London anywhere to see him.
I've never gone anywhere to see a singer before, but I'm getting on, you know. But I come to see him.
Demis really knew how to work an audience. He would walk to the front of the stage, he would ask the girls to come forward. If we tried to put security men in the front to keep them back, he'd say, no, absolutely not, let the girls come. I remember having lots of shouting going on between me and the so-called security staff because these girls were just crazy.
I had a lot of gifts, a lot of fan mail, and I had some interesting encounters, which I don't think they are for this show to talk about.
The ladies weren't the only ones who loved Demis. He also proved very popular with British comedians. Take me
home. I think he set himself up to be lampooned, didn't he? I mean, you can't go around with these floating caftans and not be lampooned.
He never complained about it. In fact, some of them he used to really laugh out loud at.
Don't forget that the comedian lives out of that. It's his job. And it is very important for a comedian to take the goofy, if we can say, out of celebrities.
He was happy that he was being talked about.
So happy that he joined in on the joke. Even to the point of forming his own double act.
I see that you're wearing a very nice caftan.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Demis. It's the little things I ran up myself as a compliment to you.
Mm. Oh,
Basil Brush was a cult show in England, and I enjoyed it because the guy that was behind the puppet was a very clever and talented man.
I say, Mr. Demis, what's Greek for boom, boom?
Well, it's boom, boom, that's it.
Watch it, I'll do the boom, booms.
Okay.
This is why I say that I had a lot of fun by mocking that image they were giving to me.
The image achieved one more big hit for Demis, but sadly, after Forever had gone, so did any more UK chart success. Thankfully, in 1977, an iconic TV play meant that the caftan-clad crooner will never be forgotten.
He is immortalized, strangely enough, not in catalogue record sales, but in Abigail's Party, the Mike Leigh play, in which the horrifying hostess insists on hearing Demis Roussos.
And
Angela likes Demis Roussos, Tony likes Demis Roussos, I like Demis Roussos, and Sue would like to hear Demis Roussos. So please, do you think we could have Demis Roussos on?
Abigail's Party was one of those seminal moments of television.
Would anybody mind if I turn this next track up? Because it's my favourite, it's Forever and Ever, and I'd like us all to hear it. Anybody mind?
Beverly from Abigail's Party sort of sums up the typical Demis Roussos fan, the sort of slightly older suburban housewife who'd maybe, you know, had a bit of a naughty holiday in Greece, that kind of thing.
Do you think he's sexy, Ange?
Yes. It's a pity he's so fat.
Yeah, but he doesn't sound it though, does he, when you hear him?
That was good because that was a cult show. And I'm very happy that my song was like, you know, like part of that.
Ange? Imagine making love to this, do you know what I mean?
Well, that'll survive for decades. So there you are, Demis, a place in history.
The caftan is now history, but Demis has survived. He's still out there, and 2007 sees him celebrate 40 years of serenading.
When you lie close to me, my heart is aflame.
Today, I reached the point where I consider myself as a world music artist and I feel very comfortable with it. Okay, I don't have a number one as I had back in the 70s, but for me, that doesn't mean anything.
Demis's appeal still lingers on. Possibly in the UK, we don't understand how big Demis really is. He's determined, absolutely determined, to ensure his career goes on forever and ever.
Sing the Bible and put it over in so many different ways.
Destiny.
He was cruel in the caftan.
The image was part of a snowball that has been created through record companies and managements. The most important thing...
These ridiculous caftans, and yet women adored them.
Different he was with a capital D.
He could sing the news and make it sound happy or sad. He could sing
in my head was the music.
He actually has a track record which is quite interesting if you go into it. He was in a fairly progressive band called Aphrodite's Child with Vangelis early in his life, in which he played bass.
A dishy young Demis and his psychedelic chums had a hippie hit in 1968 with this sound.
Well, what do we want to listen to then, Beverly?
Demis Roussos.
Ever and ever, forever and ever, you'll be the one.
Demis Roussos always seemed to be this unlikely heartthrob, didn't he? Because he was totally the wrong shape, as they were all the
Handel Tapper.
Green and tears in the sun.
We did three albums. Two of them were like pop albums. And the third one was a much more serious album.
After going all apocalyptic, Aphrodite...